My dear sisters and brothers, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On a certain Sabbath, Jesus went into the synagogue and taught. And there was a man there whose right hand was withered. The scribes and the Pharisees watched Jesus closely to see if he would cure on the Sabbath, so that they might discover a reason to accuse him. But Jesus realized their intentions and said to the man with the withered hand, "Come up and stand before us." And he rose and stood there. Then Jesus said to them, "I ask you, is it lawful to do good on the Sabbath rather than to do evil, to save life rather than to destroy it?" Looking around at them all, Jesus then said to him, "Stretch out your hand." He did so, and his hand was restored. But they became enraged and discussed together what they might do to Jesus. My dear friends, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated for a while. Again, my dear sisters and brothers, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Father.
There are certain things that we put together, and they are good when they are together. For example, when it comes to food, puto and dinuguan are good together. Lugaw and tokwat baboy are good together. And when it comes to dress, shorts and flip-flops are good together. May mga bagay that we put together, and they are good when they are together. But there are also certain things that when they are together, they are not good. And also, they are very dangerous. They say that you cannot eat fruit and at the same time drink milk together in the morning. Pwedeng kumulo ang iyong tiyan, especially kapag yung fruit is pineapple or something that very acidic. There are certain things that we do not put together. For example, we don't put together when it comes to clothing, jeans, and former shoes. We don't put them together. And in our gospel, in our first reading today, St. Paul was very clear that there are certain things that when they are together are not good, but at the same time, very dangerous. Kapag yung dalawang bagay na yun, pinagsama, hindi lang masama kung hindi delikado. What are those two things that when they are together are very dangerous? Sin and pride. Sin and pride, when they are together, they are very, very dangerous. In our first reading, St. Paul called the attention of the people in Corinth, telling them that it is widely reported that there is immorality among you. An immorality of a kind not found even among pagans. Take note of what he said. Immorality of a kind not found even among pagans. As if St. Paul was telling them, this is something unthinkable, something unacceptable, and something that is unchristian. And what is that immorality that St. Paul was talking about in our first reading? A man living with his father's wife. A man living with his father's wife. For St. Paul, that sin, that immorality is unthinkable, unacceptable, unchristian, unbecoming of a follower of Jesus. I think sometimes we also have to check if there are certain things in us and things that we have been doing that are unchristian or not becoming of a disciple of Jesus. And how would we feel if a person finds out that we are doing something like that? I had been a formator before in the seminary for 17 years before I was transferred in the parish where I am right now. And I will never forget kapag merong seminarian na malalaman kong may ginagawang hindi tama, I will call the seminarian. And I will ask the seminarian, "Do you want to tell me something? Do you want to tell me something? I am waiting for him to really confess the sin or the thing that he had done, the wrong thing that he had done. Kapag sinabi ng bata, Father, wala naman po. And then I will tell him about his fault. And then sometimes a seminarian would say, Father, sino po ang nagsabi? Father, sino po ang nagsabi? And if ever I hear that, I will tell the boy, hindi na mahalaga, it doesn't matter who said it. I'm asking you, have you done it? Because sometimes we are very much upset if a person is telling someone that we had done something wrong or something evil. But in our first reading, St. Paul is telling us, and you are inflated with pride. That makes it worse. That the person is doing something immoral and they know about it, but at the same time, they were very prideful of what that person had been doing. This is what I have been telling you a while ago. Two things are very dangerous when they are together. Sin and pride. Kasi kapag yung tao, masama na nga, mayabang pa, ay delikado yan. The person will never admit what he or she has done. That person will always point fingers at others, will always blame others for what he or she has done. There is no acceptance if there is no humility. That's why in our first reading, St. Paul even used the analogy of yeast. And that is very powerful when he said, your boasting is not appropriate. Do you not know that a little yeast leavens all the dough? Clear out the old yeast so that you may become a fresh batch of dough inasmuch as you are unleavened. Very clear, St. Paul used the symbol of yeast. Very simple and yet very powerful. Kapag nilagyan mo raw ng lebadura mismo, no, yung dough, yung harina, aalsa. And think same thing with sin. When yung sin mismo may appear to be not that dangerous at the very beginning, pero kapag ito hindi mo in-address at the very beginning, then you will have a problem at the end. Kasi aalsayaan, you will get accustomed to it. And then later on, it will be acceptable to you. And at the same time, you will also ask other people to do it. Ikaw mismo, pagtatanggol mo ang iyong sarili at pagtatanggol mo rin yung mga tao na gumagawa ng masama. Kaya nga in our first reading, St. Paul was very clear in telling us, clear the old yeast. Tanggalin yung luma. Clear the old yeast. And then at the end he said, let us celebrate the feast, not with the old yeast, the yeast of malice and wickedness, but with the unleavened yeast of sincerity and truth. He said, do not celebrate malice. Do not celebrate wickedness. Because sometimes we are celebrating all these things and we see it also in social media. No? Ano ang sabi diyan ni St. Paul? What we have to celebrate is sincerity and truth. Yun ang dapat pinopropagate natin. Yun ang dapat pinagdiriwang natin. Yun ang dapat pinapalakpakan natin. Yun ang dapat sinusuportahan natin. Hindi yung kasamaan at kasinungalingan. Kung hindi yung katotohanan at yung katapatan. And I think our first reading is very much connected to our gospel. Because in our gospel, the scribes and the Pharisees were watching Jesus very closely to see if he would cure on the Sabbath so that they might discover a reason to accuse him. That's very sad, no? Because they were watching Jesus closely if he would cure on the Sabbath, and their intention is to use it against him para merong magamit laban sa kanya. I think it applies to all of us, no? If we don't like a person, we will always watch that person very closely. Talagang pagmamatsyaga natin yung taong ayaw na ayaw natin. Titignan natin ilang beses siyang papalpak, ilang beses siyang magkakamali, ilang beses siyang makakaroon ng problema sa kanyang buhay. And that is when we celebrate yung downfall ng ating kapwa. Pero in our gospel, Jesus asked the man with a withered hand to stand in front of everyone. And he gave this challenge to everyone, asking, I ask you, is it lawful to do good on the Sabbath rather than to do evil, to save life rather than to destroy it? A while ago, we were talking about immorality. But for Jesus, it is also immoral if a person knows that someone is in need and is not doing anything. It is very immoral because that is also our responsibility. And that is the downfall of the scribes and the Pharisees. They always use as an alibi the Sabbath law. Eh kasi Sabbath, bawal gumawa ng anumang bagay. Eh kasi Sabbath, bawal tumulong sa iyong kapwa. Eh kasi Sabbath, bawal magpagaling. And then Jesus said to that person, stretch out your hand. Maganda yung simbolong yun. Stretch out your hand. Because the hand of that person being withered is lifeless. No? Kasi yung kamay ng lalaki ay tuyo at walang buhay. Ibig sabihin, wala yung function. Ibig sabihin, it is there, pero it is not very useful. As if Christ was telling everyone, the law is there, but you are abusing the law. The law is there, but you are not using it properly. That's why in our gospel, Jesus was telling everyone, not only that man, stretch out your hand. Stretch out your hand. Why? Kasi baka sa ating ding buhay, meron tayong mga hand that are there, but they are useless. Why? Because we are not using them properly. We have conscience, but the question is, are we also using our conscience? Are we also deciding based on our right conscience? Maaaring we have skills, we have talents, and we have the capacity to help other people. But the question is, are we also using these things to be of help to one another? Stretch out your hand. Jesus is always giving us that command. Why? Because sometimes the problem is that it is there, but we are not doing anything about it. We know that someone is doing something wrong, but we are not speaking against it. And sometimes we are simply smiling or laughing about that and accepting it as something very normal in our society. At the end of our gospel, we were told, Jesus did so, or the man did so, and his hand was restored. But they became enraged and discussed together what they might do to Jesus. The word restored, restored. That is what Jesus wants to do with us. He wants to restore us. Not only our withered hands, but even our withered conscience, but even our withered minds, but even our withered hearts. There are certain things that when they are together are very dangerous. Sin and pride, when together, are very dangerous. My dear friends, all of us, we commit sin, but not all of us are prideful. As long as we remain humble, wherever we commit certain sins, we could easily admit it and ask the Lord for the grace to change it. Delikado kapag yung tao masama na pero mayabang pa. Amen. When someone is doing wrong or bad thing and someone is defending him or her, usually our comment is because he or she is his or her friend. Kasi kaibigan. My dear sisters and brothers, a real friend is not someone who will defend you when you are wrong, but someone who will correct you whenever you are wrong. Ang kaibigan, hindi nagtatanggol kapag mali ang kaibigan. Ang kaibigan, nagtutuwid sa kanyang kaibigan. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you and your families, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. We now go in peace and remain in God.
Thanks be to God.
Humayo at ipahayag ang mabuting balita na